Shut up and sit down.
Hello, my name is Justin Adams.
I'm Patrick Dolan.
And welcome to Neighborly Discussions.
Oscars!
Let me come over and give you some Oscar. Oscars are tomorrow,
yep.
Hopefully, and just to say that we're going to apologize really quick, because we always have technical difficulties, and if this is late, then,
oops. Post-Oscar special.
Post-Oscar special!
Afterwards.
Oscars after night.
Oscars after night.
There we go.
Now it's definitely going to be after Oscars.
Well, after midnight. Oscars after midnight.
Okay,
you're going to edit the shit out of this
The shit out of it. Oh, we are only going to be focusing on Best Picture, mostly, because everything that's nominated for Best Picture is nominated for everything else.
Yeah.
And we are going to just go down the line and talk about some of the Best Picture nominees and maybe talk about other things that they're nominated for and what we want to win. And what we do not want to win, what we think does not deserve to be on this list at all.
And maybe some potential Oscar snubs.
Yes, we have at least one.
Yes.
I know of. So yeah, let's get into it.
Let's start from the bottom. So the first picture is Hidden Pictures. Hidden Figures.
Hidden Pictures.
Hidden Pictures. So we'll start from the bottom of the list. The first movie is Hidden Figures. This film did receive a total of 3 nominations. This is one of the Best Picture nominations that I did actually get to see, and it was a very well-made movie. I'm a big fan of Apollo 13, and I kind of got that kind of vibe through the whole movie, just especially the ending. The control room sequences were very, very similar. But all in all, it was just a great movie. The performances in it were fantastic. Kevin Costner killed it again.
Always.
You know, aside from... 3 Days to Kill, every movie he's made in the last 5 years has been pretty fucking good.
Yeah, because he knows how to be the old man now. He knows how to choose his roles as the supporting dude, and he's kind of fine with it.
And he's Superman's dad.
Yeah, Superman's dad. Oh, I really liked Hidden Figures, but it was, Octavia Spencer was nominated for Best Supporting Actress, and I don't agree. I thought
Taraji P.
Henson was way better.
The movie was fantastic, a lot of great performances, but will it win?
No.
I don't think so.
Yeah, there's some buzz that's saying that it might win Best Picture, but...
It did win the SAG Award for Best Ensemble Cast.
Yeah, I don't think that it's gonna... There's so many other... I think it's a great movie. I think it's something that people should see because it's important, and it's 3 strong female leads and whatnot, but I don't think it's gonna win Best Picture. Octavia Spencer is gonna win Best Supporting Actress. Because again, I felt like she was just Octavia Spencer.
Yeah,
I didn't feel like she was doing anything new. I felt like they just nominated her because that was their safe bet.
Yeah, could be.
I thought Taraji P. Henson, though, really brought it out there. That scene when she's talking about having to run to the bathroom.
Yes.
Is amazing.
Yeah.
And I thought that was Oscar gold right there, and they just completely ignored it.
Yeah.
What's next?
Hell or High Water with 4 nominations.
I love that movie.
This movie was great. The term modern-day Western especially gets thrown around. A lot in modern day cinema because westerns were one of the genres that kept Hollywood afloat.
Yeah, Logan right now is being called a contemporary western.
Yeah, being called a contemporary superhero western.
Yeah.
And Hell or High Water is just, it's got a slow pace to it, but it's not a slow pace that drags the movie down. It just gives you the chance to absorb every performance in it. Chris Pine, Ben Foster, Jeff Bridges, they're all fantastic.
Yeah, Jeff Bridges especially.
He was nominated Best Supporting Actor as well.
Well deserved. I read people are he's just doing R.I.P.D.
Well, I think I even mentioned that. I mean, his voice is very similar to his character in R.I.P.D., and I couldn't help but, which is one of the reasons I don't think he's going to win. It just, we've seen that Jeff Bridges before, or at least I have. But will it win Best Picture? I don't think so. If, it's one that, I wouldn't be upset if it didn't, but I really don't think it is with, some of the other flicks that are on the list.
I would definitely not put my left testicle out for that movie.
He doesn't ever write one. Next one is Fences.
Fences! Haven't seen it.
I haven't seen it either. It's got a total of 4 nominations. It's based off an award-winning play.
Denzel Washington directed it.
He stars in it. Viola Davis.
That's who's going to win. Like that's
She wasn't nominated.
For Best Supporting Actress?
Oh, okay. I thought you meant Best Actress.
No, she was nominated for Best
Supporting. Oh, okay. All right.
Yeah, she's going to win. I've only seen the trailers and I've only seen clips, but... but that just seems like a movie. Like the reason why I haven't seen it is because it just seems like a performance movie.
Yeah, you know?
And
well, like Jackie is a performance
exactly.
movie.
Exactly, and I'm not really into those movies. Like them, just like I like them sometimes. Like I thought Split was a performance movie too because it was just for James McAvoy to show all like his entire range, and I feel like that's what this movie is too.
Yeah, but actors can do that playing one character. You don't need to play 23 characters to show your complete range.
Yeah, that movie is bad. I think that it's not going to win. It's not going to win Best Picture. But that's another thing that people are talking about. Like, Denzel Washington might win Best Actor.
Best Actor. He won the SAG Award. And Casey Affleck won the Globe, didn't he? For Best Drama, Male Performance.
Yeah, and I think that Denzel Washington might win just because of that, again, like that Oscars like to fall back on the things that they've done before, and I'm pretty sure this is like his 9th nomination, or like...
Yeah.
His third win, or it's going to be like his third win.
Yeah, he's won 2, I think. He won for Training Day and he won for Glory.
Yeah.
I don't think he's won any other.
Oh, wait, did he win for Glory?
Yeah, he won Best Supporting Actor for
nice.
Glory.
Good. Earned. But, yeah, I don't think it's gonna win Best Picture, but it might win Best Actor. That's a strong option right there. I think that might happen.
And then I think its 4th nomination is Best Adapted Screenplay.
Yeah,
if I'm not mistaken.
Wilson.
Yeah.
Yeah, and also Denzel Washington isn't being sued for sexual harassment right now. So
yeah, but I don't have a comeback for that.
Exactly.
Next picture on the list is Lion. Haven't seen it either. Dev Patel's in it.
Nicole Kidman.
I'm not sure who the director is.
I'm not sure either.
I'm not even really sure what it's about.
I know it's basically a Google search ad. Like this kid, he loses his parents, and Nicole Kidman's his adopted mom, and then he goes to find his parents by Google search, and Google, and then goes on a journey by Google. And Google. And Google.
Jesus.
And
that
Google.
Sounds...
And Google.
That sounds not interesting.
If you look
at
the poster, dude, the poster is the Google bar and Dev Patel doing this.
Wow.
It's a Google ad. But I think that it looks interesting. Like, I like stories of, like, people redeeming themselves and trying to find out who you are and whatnot. But don't use a product that everybody uses. It's stupid. Honestly, I think it is. But Nicole Kidman's getting nominated for this. She didn't win anything before. Like, she's just getting nominated for a bunch of shit. And same thing with Dev Patel. This is like one of those movies that the Oscars always choose, but we know it's not gonna win. It's just being celebrated as a really, really good movie. Because I know it's nominated for cinematography too, and for score and for writing.
Well,
so it's probably a pretty movie. But
yeah,
again,
it's got a total of 6 nominations. So
yeah.
But I haven't seen it, so I don't have much to add on it. God, this is like going to be the worst fucking Oscar special.
No!
Next movie on the list is Manchester by the Sea. That one got 6 nominations as well. I haven't seen this. Justin, you have?
Yeah, it's great. It's a really good movie, but it's super sad. It's a downer. Major downer. But Casey Affleck is freaking amazing. Like, that's not a lie. Like, everyone's saying that that this is the best performance of his career, and I really... hate hearing stuff like that because then I have to maybe not agree with them, and I agreed with them. I thought that he was really freaking good in it, but it's really him and Denzel on who's going to win
the Best Actor.
Yeah, it's really between them because everyone else, I can't, like Ryan Gosling. I love him in La La Land, but he's not gonna win.
Next movie on the list, Hacksaw Ridge, another movie with 6 nominations.
Haven't seen it.
I did see it. And this would be my pick to win Best Picture.
Really?
If La La Land doesn't get it.
Really?
Hacksaw Ridge, I say this a lot in inner circles, Rusty would agree, is that Mel Gibson may be a crazy fucking racist motherfucker, but that dude can direct the hell out of a fucking movie.
Just like how Woody Allen may be.
Yeah. He likes to dip his stick in little girls, but he can fucking direct the hell out of a movie.
Dip his stick in little girls.
Yeah, you might want to cut that one.
Nope. That's gonna be the title of this Oscar special. Dick your stick in some little girl.
The one thing I can say, without a doubt, is that even out of all the movies I've seen for the Best Actor nominations, I think Andrew Garfield deserves the Best Actor award. You were saying it's either Casey Affleck or Denzel Washington. But I've seen Andrew Garfield play Spider-Man. Mm-hmm. And he was a great Peter Parker / Spider-Man, one of the best. And then watching him in Hacksaw Ridge, there were moments where you knew you were watching Andrew Garfield, but you didn't see Andrew Garfield, and that is just
a fucking... You saw Peter Parker. Yeah, the only reason why I say that Andrew Garfield might not win, or is even being talked about, is because of that. Like, no one's really talking about him anymore. Everyone was talking about Hacksaw Ridge
until
La La Land came in and swooped it.
Next movie on the list, 8 nominations, Moonlight.
Yes, this movie is amazing.
Moonlight was a beautifully told story, fantastically acted, but it's just one of those movies. I just don't get the hype out of it. I know. It was a fantastic movie. I was glued to the screen when I was watching it, but I just feel like it's being a little overhyped. You've seen so many movies over over the course of my lifetime. I've seen so many movies about, you know, about a young black youth growing up in the ghetto. You got Boys to the Hood, Menace to Society. Now this movie Do the Right Thing. This movie kind of deconstructed that in a way where they only showed 3 specific aspects of this boy's life. And no filler in between, no text on screen telling you what happened. It goes from him being 10 to him being 17 to him being in his late 20s to early 30s. And characters disappear. And the one thing I liked about it is that, you know, they're mentioned, like the mentions of a funeral here and there, but they don't really...
It's not a big moment.
They don't take time out of this character's journey to see what... You just know this person who had an impact on this kid's life when he was 10 is dead now when he's 17.
Spoilers!
Yeah. They don't explain why, but they don't have to.
Yeah, I thought that it was a fantastic movie. I agree with you with most of the things that you say besides that it's overhyped. I think the hype is, like, it's solid because it's such a well-made movie. Like, there's this one scene where his mom, he was nominated too, I forgot her name.
Naomi Harris.
Oh, she was fantastic. But there's this part where she's yelling at him, and there's like this pink lighting.
Yeah.
And you only hear the music, which the music is nominated too, which the music is amazing.
Yeah.
The movie is just, it's one of those movies where I feel like I'm actually watching a movie, you know? Like, yeah. I'm not watching something where a director is, even though I'm pretty sure that, like, he was just pouring his heart out, but it's just not just him just being like, oh, check, this is what happened to me. I'm so sad. Like, he just really showed this kid's moments and, like, in all of these moments, how they inspired him to be the person that he wants to be at the very end. Yeah. And the last moment, the last little section is, like, one of the most beautiful things I've ever seen in my entire life.
And it's, for lack of a better term, like, you know, Moonlight does have a kind of, sort of a happy ending to it.
Yeah.
And it's very, very heartfelt. And there was one other thing I wanted to say about it, but I can't think of it, so we'll just move on. I just don't see it winning. Like you said before, I think the 8 nominations for this movie, if anything, maybe they'll give Barry Jenkins the directing.
I don't know. I think that it might have a good chance. Like, I honestly do think that La La Land's gonna sweep everything, but Moonlight is such a, that, like, compared to last year's Oscars So White thing, Moonlight is such a good movie that I can actually tell that they weren't just choosing it to be like, oh.
I sort of thought the opposite with the way Fences I felt it was that was way. Overhyped.
Because Fences, I haven't heard every single review I read about Fences, no one's saying that's a good movie. They're saying that there are good performances. Everyone, that's all they're saying. So the fact that that's nominated for Best Picture, I feel like that's why that they're like, I agree with Hidden Figures because that is, Hidden Figures and Moonlight, they're both, they're proving something, and they're both doing something that hasn't really been done before. Like the last movie that was nominated for her best picture that was starring all black women was The Color Purple, I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
And and Moonlight was like actually showing like a kid who is trying so hard not to be gay.
Yeah.
You know? And that's something that it has been shown on film before, but not really like this. Like, I've seen it done so many times.
No, it was done in a...
It's very beautiful.
I can't say enough about the way it was filmed and the way that the script was written.
Yeah, the script is amazing. I feel like that is definitely going, if anything, that's probably going
to
work.
It's a bold move to show the narrative of a character's journey, but only take three specific moments in this person's life and just focus on those. And I mean, they don't show anything else. Next movie on the list, Arrival. Again, another one with 8 nominations. This one I heard about, Denis Villeneuve. He did Prisoners,
Enemy, and shit. What was that one they did last year?
Yeah. Anyway.
Dennis Sicario.
Yes. Oh, he did Sicario. Mm-hmm. Oh, Sicario was great.
Yep.
So Denis Villeneuve directed it. He's also up for a directing award as well. This is a movie, when I first saw it, I thought, oh man, this movie is very, very slow. And like, it was a watch movie for me. I kept looking at my watch, not distracting myself from the story, but just kept looking at my watch. Mm-hmm. Like, oh, 15 minutes went by. That felt like an hour. Okay. 10 more. Oh. But then once they get to the point where they start like going into the ship and she starts like writing the language for the creatures
and taking off her
and it really picked up a lot of steam, and then it just started like tension and suspense just started growing and growing. This is one movie that I absolutely think is going to win sound and sound effects editing.
Oh, yeah.
Even amidst, you know, movies like Rogue One and Jungle Book. The sound in this movie tells a fucking story in a way that is just awesome. And I'm really, really eager to watch it again. I've only seen it the one time, but the more time has gone by and I've thought about it, I'm like, damn, that really was a fantastically done movie.
Just the first, I think like the first like 20 to 30 minutes, and the same. Just it was just too watchy for me, you know.
Like, it really is, but like, sit through it, get through it, and
Amy Adams, she was nominated for anything, right?
No, there was that whole thing, like there was that whole fuck up at the Oscar announcements where, like, the nominations that were being pumped into their ears or that were on the envelopes were not the final decisions, and like Amy Adams' name was read as being a Best Actress nominee, and then they had to come back out and be like, I'm sorry, Amy Adams was not one of the nominees, and it happened to someone else, I think a director.
Instead, they nominated fucking Meryl Streep.
Meryl Streep, she's a fucking great actress, but I haven't seen Florence Foster Jenkins, so I can't say anything about her particular performance in that.
She was also nominated for Into the Woods. They just nominate for anything.
Yeah, well, she is a good actress, man.
Ugh. I think she's a good actress too, but like 14 nominations, every single movie that she does. Come on! All right, what's next?
This is it. La La Land. 14 nominations, tied for the most amount of nominations.
It's
with,
gonna win
with All About Eve and Titanic.
Really? Oh shit!
Yeah. La La Land is my pick to win Best Picture. It was my favorite movie of the year.
Mine too.
I have a feeling Emma Stone will probably win Best Actress.
Oh, yeah.
I don't want Ryan Gosling to win Best Actress. As much of a man crush as I had on the Sebastian character in that movie,
same,
and how I just like kind of wanted to be him and throw myself into those dance moves, and well, not quite, but it's just he was a cool fucking character, cool, like quirky.
Oh, yeah.
All the performances in the movie were absolutely brilliant. I cannot say enough about the cinematography in that film.
Yeah.
You look at some of the tracking shots in that film, and it defies expectations of what good fucking cinematography can be. Yeah. Like, you think, like, oh, no, I've seen this great... Like, just watch La La Land and seriously just soak yourself into some of these moving camera shots that he does, and it's just phenomenal. And the choreography alone... In the opening number.
The open number is so good.
I think it will probably win music and song categories. Costume design, I'm not sure if it's going to... I don't think it'll sweep everything, but I definitely... It was my favorite fucking picture of the year, and I've seen it at least 5 or 6 times.
Yeah, I love it. I thought that it is one of the... It is, like, the best movie of the year. And I was talking about this with him and Rusty, but there's so many freaking people, so much backlash against this goddamn movie with people not even seeing it. Because I understand, though, like, these two extremely good-looking white people dancing. No, I get it, because this is the complaint that everybody's having. Like, there's no black people in it. The only black person's in there is John Legend. He's the villain. He's trying to be a white savior, trying to save jazz, but he's a white guy. I get it, ladies and gentlemen. But... fuck you. Honestly, fuck yourselves, okay? My dad, he was a musician, and he loved fucking jazz, and he was the same kind of guy. Just, it's not white savior shit, they just fucking love jazz. Fuck yourself. God damn it. No, and also, people, like, refusing to see it just because it's a musical, and it's, like, these two really good-looking people. Fuck yourself. Just watch it. Just watch it. It's a good movie. And the one shot alone where they want to kiss, they want to kiss, they're not kissing, they can't kiss, everything is happening, like, all these obstacles, and they finally kiss, that one shot of just going in front of them, and then backing out and having the music,
That shot starts, like, in the planetarium,
yeah.
And they're, like, kind of floating down out of the sky, and the camera zooms in on them, and they sit down, and then the camera zooms in, they do the kiss, and then it does the big zoom out and the Hollywood, like, closing circle, lens thing.
I love it.
And it was just so old-fashioned Hollywood. Like, if you're a fan of, like, Fred Astaire and Ginger Roger movies, Gene Kelly movies, like, do yourself a favor and go see it.
And
it is...
Like, it's not even that. Like, it is a homage to Gene Kelly and all of those greats, but it is its own thing. And that's why I keep trying to tell people. That's why I keep trying to tell everyone who's, like, not wanting to see it because they're like, oh, this isn't this. I'm a musical theater person. I really personally do not want to see that because of my musical theater experience. No, okay,
that just sounds like pretentiousness.
It is, right? And it really is, and it's people being full of themselves, and the fact that they think that they're better than a movie that's way better than they will ever be is pretty astonishing to me. I'm a very cocky person, and I know when to get off my high horse, and La La Land is certainly one that can be on its high horse and stay there for a while. Hi, La La Land. Bye, La La Land. You're going to win everything.
You know, and if it does sweep everything, I think it totally deserves it.
Yeah, best director, best picture. I don't think the writing is going to win because I think, honestly, if we want to bash anything about La La Land, we can bash the script and some of the little things. But
yeah,
it's still a good movie. Like, it's even the flaws are good. It's just like Get Out. Like, when we saw, like, it's like a movie that you can see the problems with it. You can see, like, okay, there's this and that and that, but it's just such a likable movie and such a well-made movie. And if you, the opening scene, like, and that's why I keep telling people who just don't refuse to see it, if the second you see that opening scene, you're gonna be amazed.
Yeah.
You're not gonna, it's impossible to sit there and be a cynical dick and be like, oh, that person that was skating, he kind of messed with the camera right there. Oh, the lighting's a little messed up. Fuck you. You try doing it. You try making that fucking scene. One-shot LA freeway dance number. God, I hate people. I'm done.
Wow. Tell us how you really feel, Justin.
Yeah.
You're ruining your Oscar clothes.
Oh, I know. I'm getting nice and sweaty now.
I think La La Land... does deserve to win everything. I hope it doesn't. There, like I said, I hope Andrew Garfield wins Best Actor.
Yeah.
I cannot even begin to tell you how amazing he is in that fucking movie. And if you're gonna, even if you don't like war movies, please at least just watch it for his performance alone. Hey, it was kind of on the fly. I hope you didn't mind our Oscar special too much.
No, I think this went really well.
Okay.
Really quick before we leave, let's talk about a quick snub that I'm pretty sure me and you totally agree. Like,
and I'm sure Invisible Rusty would agree with us. Mm-hmm. So, the Nice Guys.
Nice Guys.
One of my favorite movies of the year. Like, I mean, just if it's Nice Guys and La La Land just keep doing this on my list for best movie of the year. And The Nice Guys is one of the best detective movies I've ever seen. It's also one of the best fucking comedies I've ever seen. Mm. It is just so well done. Shane Black, who basically just started, didn't start, but just one of the innovators of the buddy cop drama.
Yeah, it's, I think that hysterical. At least it should have been nominated for Best Original Screenplay.
Yes, absolutely.
And that's the only thing that I wanted it to be
nominated for. Or maybe an Oscar actor nomination for even the girl who plays Ryan Gosling's daughter in it is
freaking really good.
Hysterical.
No, yeah, I think that the main thing about every Shane Black movie, and the same thing with Kiss Kiss Bang Bang, is that the script, like, he knows how to write such a good script, such a funny script, mm-hmm. and he's never been nominated for best original screenplay, like best. He's never been nominated.
Not even Kiss Kiss Bang Bang.
Nope.
That didn't.
Well. Nothing. Like, he's in. It blows my mind because that both of those movies are such well written movies that I feel like its box office performance is what has the Academy like not looking at it, because both Kiss Kiss Bang Bang and The Nice Guys made its budget back, but that's it. They just made its budget back.
Yeah.
Like they both like made like $40 million in the box office, and it's because of stupid marketing. But I think that the movies were still, I thought they were really fucking good. One movie that did get nominated for best original screenplay though that I really liked was 20th Century Women. Have you heard of that one?
No.
It's such a good movie. You should check that out. I thought that should have been nominated for more things. Like Annette Bening was really good, but it did get nominated for best original screenplay, which I was happy about that. But I honestly would have taken out 20th Century Women to put in The Nice Guys, because I think the script is just way funnier, and it just has so many things going on, so many twists and turns, and I love those kind of movies.
Yeah, and it's just filled with quirky, weird characters. It's unabashedly violent, and it doesn't hide at all what type of movie it is. That's our Oscar special, ladies and gentlemen. So watch the Oscars. If this video makes it online before the Oscars, they're on tomorrow, Sunday, February 24th at 6:00, I believe, on ABC. It might not be ABC. I don't know.
NBC's Golden Globes and ABC.
Yeah. You know what? We'll do what they do on television. Check your local listings.
Check your local listings.
For the Oscars.
Yeah.
6:00 tomorrow, February 24th. I'm excited for him. He's excited for him. Maybe we'll do a little Oscar post-rap show after all the winners are decided.
Oh, yeah. We're going to be pissed off. I know for a fact there's going to be something that's going to make us mad and need to bust out a camera.
Yeah. I hope, if there's one award I had to go and predict, or the one award that I would give out myself, I would have to say I'd give it to Andrew Garfield for Hacksaw Ridge. If you had to give one award, if you had the power to give one award in everything that is nominated, which one would it be and to who?
Oh, man. That's
and it could be cinematography, director, like...
I think I would... Can we do things that are not even nominated? Or does it have to be nominated?
I would say they'd have to be nominated. All right. Sorry.
Well, like, then I say La La Land. There's like, that's...
All right.
There's really nothing else like that really blew my mind this year. Well, or either that or Hell or High Water winning for Jeff Bridges.
Yeah.
Because I like that movie a lot.
Yeah, that was a good flick.
I really, really enjoyed it.
Oh. Okay, so...
if you want to follow me on Twitter, you can. @IamJustin_420.
BuffMovie33.
And remember, Oscars tomorrow, and we are going to have another Neighborly Discussions. You guys are going to have double trouble.
Let's see.